Dassault Mirage 3. The Dassault Mirage II is a family of single, dual-seat, single-engine, and fighter aircraft developed and manufactured by French aircraft company Dassault Aviation. It was the first Western European combat aircraft to exceed Mach 2 in horizontal flight, a feat which was achieved on 24 October 1958. In 1952, the French government issued its specification, calling for a lightweight, all-weather interceptor. Amongst the respondents were Dassault with their design. Initially known as the Mirage I, following favorable flight testing held over the course of 1954, in which speeds of up to Mach 1.6 were attained, it was decided that a larger follow-on aircraft would be required to bear the necessary equipment and payloads. An enlarged Mirage II proposal was considered, as well as Maryland 610, Cavalier, three versions, but was discarded in favor of a further developed design, powered by the newly developed Snecmaratar after-burning turbojet engine, designated as the Mirage III. In October 1960, the first major production model, designated as the Mirage IIIC, performed its maiden flight. Initial operational deliveries of this model commenced in July 1961. A total of 95 Mirage IIICs were obtained by the French Air. The Mirage IIIC was rapidly followed by numerous other variants. Dassault Mirage 5. The Dassault Mirage 5 is a French supersonic attack aircraft designed by Dassault Aviation during the 1960s and manufactured in France and a number of other countries. It was derived from Dassault's popular Mirage 3 fighter and spawned several variants of its own, including the IAIKFR. Pakistani Mirage 5s are capable of nuclear weapons delivery. The Mirage rebuild factory Camra, Pakistan. The sprawling complex at Camra, west of Islamabad, reverberates at the thundering takeoff of a Mirage Rose 1. The latest aging fighter jet to have been gutted and reassembled by the Pakistani Air Force 50 years after Pakistan bought its first Mirages. Many planes in the venerable fleet are still being patched up, overhauled and upgraded for use in combat, and years after conventional wisdom dictates they should be grounded. That includes one of the first two planes originally purchased from France's Dassault in 1967, which was in a hangar at Camra after its record fifth overhaul when AFP visited recently. The techniques they have developed are reminiscent of, but far more high-tech and lethal than, the improvised methods used to keep classic American cars running on the streets of Havana. We have achieved such a capability that our experts can integrate any latest system with the aging Mirages, told by Pakistani officials. Pakistan bought its first Mirages to diversify its fleet, which in the late 1960s largely consisted of U.S.-built planes, F-104 Starfighters, T-37 Tweety Birds and F-86 Sabres. The Mirage became a popular choice, with the Air Force buying 17 different variants in later years, eventually owning the second highest number of the fighter jets after France. But Mirages flew on, also carrying out reconnaissance missions in India, and intercepting and shooting down Soviet and Afghan planes that violated Pakistani airspace during the Soviet War. Usually, the jet has two or three life cycles, each spanning around 12 years. But overhauling them abroad was expensive for Pakistan, a developing country whose budget is already disproportionately tilted toward its military and which has historically received billions in military assistance from countries such as the US. So, with the help of experts from Dassault, the Air Force decided if you want something done for the right price, you've got to do it yourself. The Mirage Rebuild Factory was established at the Pakistan Aeronautical Complex, PAC, in 1978, and in the years since has saved billions of dollars for Pakistan, according to Group Captain Mohammed Farooq, in charge of one of the maintenance hangars, though he said the exact figure was difficult to pin down. The planes take some 7 weeks to be overhauled and repainted, he said, adding that usually the MRF has the capacity for more than a dozen planes a year. Its calendar for the next decade or so is already booked up. At least 8 different Mirage variants, including the Mirage 5EF, Mirage 3DP and Mirage 3 Rose I, were in one of the maintenance hangars when AFP visited. Engineers and technicians were dismantling cockpit instrument panels and landing gear while undertaking a non-destructive inspection, essentially an X-ray to detect faults in the wings and airframe. Dozens of engines awaiting overhaul were piled in one hangar. Even planes that had suffered accidents such as fires breaking out have been patched back together at the facility. Pakistan has also been buying up discarded Mirages from other countries to bring through the facility. The most important technological improvement, developed with the help of South Africa, is the ability to integrate air-to-air refueling, the identification of friend and foe IFF system, which detects when a Mirage has been locked onto by the system of another plane, was also a key development. But even with the improvements and cost-saving measures, the aging planes are becoming more difficult to maintain. They have outlived their lives. After their overhauls, they have become highly unreliable. We even met with lots of accidents. The best option to replace them would be the Rafale, as neighbor and arch rival India, which has also flown and maintained Mirages for decades, is doing, signing a deal with Dassault in 2016. The price tag is too much for Pakistan. Instead, Pakistan plans to replace them with the JF-17 Thunder aircraft that it co-developed and co-produced with China, the original manufacturer. Even as it becomes more urgent to phase them out, Mirage's status as the grand dames of Pakistani military aviation cannot be dismissed. It is a very agile aircraft capable of penetrating deep into the enemy's territory without being detected by radar, which makes its sole mission to drop bombs on the enemy's position quite easy. It is an old aircraft, but Pakistani pilots have been flying this plane with the utmost accuracy and expertise. Why Pakistan is still using Mirage in terms of exploiting geostrategic realities: Pakistan's immediate proximity to India means that the PAF's Mirage 3/5s can deploy SAOs without needing fuel tanks to sustain a long-range flight. There is no need for it. The presence of forward operating bases, civilian airstrips and makeshift runways using highways enable the PAF to deploy and recover its aircraft with relative ease. Thus, the inherent limitation in combat radius is not an issue for the PAF in terms of airstrikes on nearby targets, albeit targets within the coverage provided by the PAF's SOW arsenal, especially the H-2 and H-4, local versions of the Denel Raptor I-2. The PAF had shown a limited measure of this capability in its response to India's attempted airstrikes over Balakot in 2019, i.e., swift retort. The PAF strike package at the Time consisted of two Mirage 5 PAR and two dual-seat Mirage IAIDAs. The PAF armed the Mirage 5 PAR with H-4s, i.e., a gliding SOW with a rocket assist motor capable of reaching a range of 120 km. Once the Mirage 5 PAR launched their H-4 ordnances, operators sitting in the rear seat of each Mirage IAIDA manually operated the H-4s to their targets using a data link-based communications protocol and the H-4's TV seeker. The PAF says it opted to intentionally miss the military targets on the other side of the line of control.